We're joined by the senior leader of the PDP, Sayyid Altaf Bukhari, the man who is running the show at present after Mehbooba Mufti. Sir, you are planning along with the other parties to form an alliance, a grind alliance, to keep the BJP, the communal forces, as your party have been saying.
Let me first correct you. I am an ordinary worker of the party. Definitely, you are right now in Lal Chowk and I represent this constituency. So it is not that I run the party. Mohtarma Mehbooba Mufti ji runs the party along with the senior leaders. I am one of the persons there. It's a fact that the leaders of three parties have agreed to join hands. This is what we have been told. That is all we have been told. What are the contours of it? When it is taking shape? Who is going to head it? Honestly, I have no knowledge of it. As and when we get any knowledge, we'll share with the media.
Sir, what made you to come together? Because you people from the National Conference to PDP to Congress, you have been loggerheads, have been blaming each other for the Kashmir situation. Now, what make you to come together?
I think you are also a Kashmiri. And the situation warrants to set aside all differences, if there were any. I think ideologically, we have no differences. Today, what is more important is you have to respond to a situation which our people are facing. Our identity is under attack. So when your identity is under attack, I don't think any difference should be remembered that we have a difference. And what are the differences? The differences are we are two political parties. We used to run it differently. Otherwise, it's the same. They want to serve the people. We want to serve the people.
Sir, if the Governor Malik dissolves the assembly before the before you are able to make the government, if he says no and goes ahead with dissolving the assembly, how are the political parties reacting to his action?
I don't think one should react to hypothesis. This is hypothesis, whether this happens. When it happens, we'll respond. As a political party, we'll respond. Right now, I don't see any such thing. Right now, I only know that, yes, I am confirming that the three parties have agreed to make a government for the meeting the aspirations of the people of Jammu and Kashmir. And since our identity 370 35A is under attack, we will try to protect it. With all, not that we did not do it. We did it when we were in the government. We did it politically. We did it legally. And we will do it more forcefully politically as well as legally.
When are you when are you announcing the big political news?
I think that will come from the leaders. Anytime soon. I don't see any problem in that. That is a decision to be taken by the leaders when they announce it.
Thank you.
All right, so that's a big admission and a big development coming in from Jammu Kashmir, where the ex-education minister and a PDP legislator, Altaf Bukhari, has made an announcement. He says they've got 60 MLAs in their favour from National Conference, from Congress and the PDP, and they are ready to form the government. The formal announcement in this regard, in this effect, is going to be made soon. Aditya Raj Kaul joining us in our studio. Zeenat is going to join us from Kashmir. Remember, she had an exclusive word with Altaf Bukhari, a political editor, Eshwara Kapoor, and also our Jammu Bureau Chief Tejinder joining us from Kashmir. A quick word from Tejinder, in fact, from you, because you're also tracking reactions from Jammu. Now, if you look at the numbers, 87 seats out of which Bukhari says they have 60. And what is the backstory? Because they are now playing on this Article 35A, Article 370, and it seems that all is being done to put BJP at the bay.
Yes, Sakal, you rightly said. Right now, these parties, if at all true, they are joining hands just to keep BJP away. We know that PDP and the National Conference, they had fought elections against each other. But them now coming closer, it's a clear indication that both these parties, they want to keep BJP away. BJP had withdrawn the support from PDP-led coalition government in the state, after which the governor rule was imposed in the state of Jammu and Kashmir. But now it seems that as the state government had to take administration had to take a decision before 19th of December because the 6 months of the governor rule was to end on 19th of December, so any decision had to be taken. Otherwise, there was no other option but to implement president's rule in the state of Jammu and Kashmir and dissolve the assembly. But now it seems that these political parties who had fought this election against against each other, they are joining hands to form the government in the state of Jammu and Kashmir. But yes, it seems that the Altaf Bukhari, the claim that 60 MLAs are supporting them seems to be a bit exaggerated claim.
Yes.
But let's see what happens in the coming days before they claim stake for the formation of the government in the state of Jammu and Kashmir. Yes, Akal.
Yes, and he was, let's get a quick word from Aishwarya here, because he was, a little tight-lipped about their next move when it comes to approaching the governors, taking the claim, etc. Though Aishwarya, he did say that the announcement of this effect is going to be made soon. What more are you picking up from your sources in the BJP and the next move when it comes to approaching governor? Aishwarya.
Sakal, at this point of time, fact is very clear that what is happening in Kashmir is that all of these opposition parties who were at loggerheads are now coming together with only one motive, to keep BJP out. But also simultaneously, we need to keep a very close tab at the governor's house, because the option was open with the governor at least 10 days back to dissolve the assembly. Because according to the constitution of Jammu and Kashmir, there is no provision under which you can extend the governor's rule. So if the governor dissolves the assembly, then you get into a position where you cannot basically approach the governor to form the government. There will be a president's rule in place, and that is something which is going to be very interesting. So we need to keep a very close watch onto the governor's house as well, that will the governor dissolve the assembly before they can stake a claim? Because that has been a school of thought within these opposition parties, Sakal. That's exactly why, after yesterday's meeting, Ghulam Nabi Azad, the senior Congress leader, suggested that they need to move fast. And that's why you see what has happened in the last 18 hours is now they are ready to form the government within the next 24. So what they have done is played BJP's game, that is quick movement, and not allowed BJP to move against them. So that is what they are trying. Yeah.
Okay. Okay, sure. Yes. Yes. Aishwarya, Tejinder, stay with us. Zenith also joins us live from Srinagar as Aditya continues to stay with us. Zenith, quickly from you. What's the sense now you're getting? What's the inside story? Is 60 MLAs and exaggerated or inflated number, or do they actually have the numbers in their favor? And talking about Altaf Bukhari, is he going to be the next man running the show?